Good afternoon, Holy Family. Before we begin Mass today, please silence any electronic devices. Today's readings are on page 328 in the Missal. Please check the bulletin for summer activities, such as Mass on the Grass, Movies on the Lawn, Parish Kids Camp, the Parish Softball Schedule, and Bible, Beer, and Barbecue with Seminarian Randy. Now let us call to mind that we are in the presence of God. Lord, we ask you for the grace to celebrate this liturgy well.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we come together, as always, around our Lord's table, we are mindful of the great gift of God's love and mercy. Let us pause for a moment and open our hearts to the fullness of these gifts.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
You, we bless you, we adore.
adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father. You take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of God, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who are my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who insult you fall upon me. I pray to you, Lord, at the time of your favor, in your great love answer me.
In your great love answer me.
In your great love answer me. Answer me, O God, out of the goodness of your love, in your
great mercy turn towards me. I am in pain and distress. I am in pain and distress. Lift your hand, protect me, O God.
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 I will praise God's name in song and glorify God with thanksgiving. This will please the Lord more than sacrifice. The lowly will hear and be glad. Take heart, you seekers of God. For the Lord hears the cry of the poor. For the Lord hears the cry of the poor.
For the Lord hears the cry of the poor.
God will save Zion and rebuild the cities of Judah. Possess it. The children of God will inherit it. The children of God will inherit it. Those who love God's name will dwell there.
Those who love God's name will dwell there.
Those who love God's name will dwell there.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Sisters and brothers, through one man, sin entered the world, and through sin, death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, though sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin, after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the graciousness of that gift of the one man, Jesus the Christ, overflow for the many. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without the Father's knowledge. Even as the hairs on your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon. It is truly good to see all of you here today. I welcome everyone viewing remotely, and I pray that you are all doing well. These readings today can be rather intimidating or even scary to think about at times. We are all called to proclaim the kingdom of God, the good news of Jesus Christ, and we should not be deterred from proclaiming the truth due to persecution. Persecution can be defined as a subjection to hostility and ill treatment, noting its similarity to oppression, abuse, discrimination, intimidation, torment, and harassment. Now, in the first reading, Jeremiah, while still a young man, is called by God to a prophetic office. This was during a turbulent time, reflecting a nation in crisis. After King Josiah's death, the nation started reverting to idolatry and other pagan practices. Jeremiah strongly opposed these changes, and for speaking the truth to the people, he was subjected to persecution by being arrested, imprisoned, abused, and disgraced, simply for calling the people back to their covenant with God. In fact, he was ultimately killed by one of his own countrymen while in exile in Egypt. In the gospel, Jesus tells us not to be afraid of those who will persecute us, telling us as disciples, we should not expect to be greater than the teacher. And it should be enough to become like the teacher. Isn't this what each one of us strive for? To become like the teacher? Like Christ in all aspects of our lives? But as we imitate Christ, we must remember that Christ endured tremendous persecutions, and we can expect nothing less. As Americans, we tend to think Christian persecution is something that happens elsewhere. But anti-Christian sentiment and persecutions are on the increase everywhere around the world, including our own country. Since May of 2020, there have been 349 attacks on churches nationwide, with 9 of those in our own state. In September 2021, the USCCB reported 95 attacks on Catholic churches. In the first 3 months of this year, there have been 63 churches attacked nationwide. In January 2021, a watch group reported that worldwide 340 million Christians face high levels of persecution. Every day around the world, some 13 Christians are killed for their faith. 12 are illegally arrested or imprisoned. 5 are abducted, and 12 churches or Christian buildings are attacked. Finally, in the West, there is a growing prejudice, ostracization, and discrimination against both Christians and their beliefs. So as Christians, how should we respond to these and other forms of persecutions? First, with an awareness the role of suffering has on evangelization. We need to actively defend religious freedom, which is one of the most important components of our response to persecution. Pope Benedict XVI told us that religious freedom is one of the foundational issues defining not only who we are as human beings, but also as a society. We should strive to develop a response characterized through the gifts and fruits of the Holy Spirit, the very same qualities exemplified by Christ in his response: remembrance, love, joy, prayer, serenity, courage, patience, docility, and hope. We can look to Jeremiah for inspiration, whose situation weighed heavy on him. But even though he was near the point of despair due to his persecutions, he had total trust in the triumph of God. Just like the prophets of the Old Testament or the apostles, we need to speak the truth, no matter how difficult or hopeless it may seem. We are called to proclaim the kingdom. St. Paul tells us, "For I have handed on to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with sacred scripture." And Jesus tells us, "What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops." In other words, our faith is not intended to be simply a personal faith, something we give to ourselves. It is intended to be shared with others. And when we do this, we need to be prepared to receive persecution. Come, Holy Spirit, set our hearts on fire and renew the face of the earth. May God bless and protect each one of us.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, the Word of the Father before all ages, God from God, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the power of his Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. And those who are dead in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in one Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In faith, we now turn to God with our hopes and needs.
For all who are called to lead the church, working to evangelize all who seek the truth, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those called to government service, striving to lead in ways of peace and justice, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For family members who serve as caregivers for the young, the elderly, and the infirmed, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this parish community, as we do our best to reflect the face of Christ to others, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all migrant workers, farmers, and their families, that their season be blessed, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the names and prayers in our book of intentions, and for all the special intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who died believing in the resurrection, we especially remember Paul Lynch, Renee Ramirez Jr., Maria Hines, Thomas Gordon, Marias Linares, Pedro Hernandez Rios, Eduardo Martinez de Jesus, and Elizabeth Smith, who died recently. At this Mass, we also remember Octavio Gonzalez. Lord, in your mercy, grant them eternal peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we lift up to you all these prayers and ask that you continue to guide us with the fullness of your Spirit, that we may live lives that reflect your goodness to others, that we may give you glory in all that we do and say. We make this prayer in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship your holy name.
sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may be past and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. Your rich in love and Your slow to anger, Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For my heart to find. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. And on that day when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. I'll worship Your holy name. I'll worship Your holy name.
Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Creator. May the Lord accept the sacrifice. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of Your mercies and mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve You may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give You thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise You, as without end we acclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Earl, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Now we join together in the prayer that Christ himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share that with one another. Oops, sorry. Peace. Thanks. Peace be with you. Thank you. Peace. Peace be with you. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
For those of you at home, we offer the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. For you live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
This is the body of Christ, beautiful, broken, and blessed. Miracle of the greatest of loves, presence of God in our midst. This is the cup that he shares, endlessly emptied and poured. Sacrifice made so that we might be saved, now and forevermore. Amen, amen. We are healed by the bread of life. Amen, amen. We are one in the body of Christ. We are one in the body of Christ. This is the body of Christ. Word become flesh by his grace. Miracle of a mystery no tongue ever could fully explain. This is the blood of the Lamb, gift of a heart open wide, poured from the cross to the altar where love comforts and fills and provides. Body of Christ. this is the body of Christ, gathered in hope and in faith, bound by this love, this body and blood, he offers again and again. All of the hunger we have, satisfied only by this. So we receive, we remember, believe, and share so that others may live.
With those who are taking the Eucharist, to those who cannot be with us, please come forward. Well, may the Lord bless you, and as you visit those who cannot join us, may you bring our concern and love, and may they be comforted by this Eucharist and your presence and your pastoral love for them. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask for your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord stand as a shelter for all who will call on his name, sing the praise and the glory of God. Could the Lord ever leave you? Could the Lord forget his love? Though a mother forsake her child, he will not shelter for all.
you turn and forsake him, he will gently call your name. Should you wander away from him, he will always take you back. Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love and the glory of God.